Hello guys, in today's video we're going to check out the best beginner cameras in 2020. I made this list based on my personal opinion and I tried to list them based on their price, quality, durability and more. To find out more information about these beginner cameras, you can check out the description below.
If you'd like to win one of these products, make sure you watch the whole video, click the like button and comment the hidden word found in this video.
At number 5, it's the Nikon D3300. Taking photography as a hobby is one of the best choices you can make, since this journey is really endless and extremely satisfying overall. For those that don't know where to start and want to find a nice beginner-friendly camera that'll deliver the value for the price and excellent functionality, I have a set of nice cameras here, starting with the extremely budget-friendly but capable Nikon D3300. The Nikon D3300 is one of the best beginner cameras in the market, and the company knows how to make some great beginner-friendly cameras. This one is equipped with a great sensor, continuous shooting mode, superb autofocus, simple controls, and it's still popular with plenty of photographers, thanks to the availability of different lenses out there. Let's take a closer look at this marvelous camera. Despite being extremely affordable and pretty old by now, the Nikon D3300 is a pretty well-built camera, just like every model in Nikon's entry level. It's made out of a single piece of polycarbonate material that makes the device lightweight and durable, and it's worth mentioning that the camera is pretty compact, measuring just 3.9 by 3 by 3.9 inches and weighs just 15.2 ounces in total. I also like the hand grip of this camera as it's pretty deep and delivers plenty of support during long shooting sessions. This entry-level camera has a pretty good autofocus system made out of 11 autofocus points, of which the center one is a cross-type. It might not look like it can do much, but it's pretty pleasing to shoot with it, since it comes with an AF-assisted illuminator and 3D tracking AF system, delivering a better performance than its direct competitors. It focuses perfectly on still subjects, and in good lighting, it's extremely fast, but it couldn't achieve the same level of quickness in suboptimal lighting. The main selling point of this entry-level camera is its 24.2 megapixel CMOS DX format sensor that's responsible for its marvelous image quality and detail reproduction on top of its colors. With its amazing battery life of 700 shots and burst shooting mode of 5 frames per second, the Nikon D3300 is one of the best budget cameras. At number 4, it's the Canon EOS Rebel SL2. There are tons of cameras in the market that boast that they're extremely easy to use, but none is easier than the excellent Canon EOS Rebel SL2. This camera, despite being extremely easy to use and one of the smallest cameras in the market, will get plenty of things done in no time, thanks to its excellent sensor, autofocus system, vari-angle touchscreen display and many more features that'll make this one of your best friends for a long time. Let's start this review by saying that the Canon EOS Rebel SL2 is the smallest DSLR in the market with a vari-angle display, as it measures 2.7 by 4.8 by 3.6 inches in total, and it weighs just 450 grams fully assembled. You can get this camera in different colors, including white, tan, silver, or the classic black version, and you can choose the one that fits your personality the best. From its build quality, you would think that this is a premium Canon camera, as it's constructed from polycarbonate resin and carbon glass fiber. It's pretty durable and sturdy, however it doesn't feel the part in the hands as the materials are pretty harsh. The deep hand grip, however, allows you to support the camera perfectly while shooting, and thanks to its lightweight, you can easily shoot one-handed. In the autofocus department, the Canon EOS Rebel SL2 may look a little lacking since it uses a 9-point autofocus system that was present in its predecessors as well, but it's not a deal-breaker at all. The AF points are aligned in the classic diamond shape and are spread pretty well around the scene. On the other hand, you'll get one cross-type autofocus point for more sensitivity. In good lighting, this system worked perfectly and pretty fast as well, while in dimly lit rooms, it wasn't far behind. On top of that, the camera was pretty fast at shooting, and I don't have anything to complain about with this super easy to use camera that'll teach you the basics of photography. At number 3, it's the Fujifilm X-T100. Next up, we have an excellent mirrorless model coming through with the Fujifilm X-T100. This camera is a premium model, but it has tons of features that beginners will find friendly, and it's very user-friendly overall, despite having tons of dials. This camera rocks a superb build quality, comes in different finishes, tons of dials and controls that'll teach you a lot about photography, and it's one of the best entry-level mirrorless models that you'll use for a long time. If you're interested in style and aesthetics, the Fujifilm X-T100 will deliver everything you desire, since you won't find a better aesthetically designed compact camera in the market. It rocks the 80s SLR camera looks with the prism and viewfinder compartment, and it gives the old-school retro vibes to everyone. Simply marvellous in each of its colours, dark silver, black and champagne gold. The build quality of the Fujifilm X-T100 is also excellent, coming in with a textured plastic body and an anodized aluminium top plate, giving it a premium feel. It isn't dust and waterproof, however, but it is super solid and sturdy, weighing about 450 grams in your hands. Its tiny size also adds further to its portability and usability. The electronic viewfinder of this camera is just excellent, allowing you to shoot in sunlight when your LCD screen is not appropriate, and the viewfinder has a 2360K dot resolution OLED screen, which is super sharp. The rear display, however, is also pretty good as it is 3 inches in size and has a resolution of 1040K dot and is vari-angle and touchscreen at the same time. This camera is packed with a sophisticated 91-point autofocus system with a phase detection setup that makes it pretty fast and accurate, regardless of the light conditions. It has 24-megapixel APS-C CMOS sensor that delivers amazing photographs with plenty of detail sharpness and Fujifilm's trademark colours, which have a beautiful vibe to them. There are also excellent film simulation modes which you can use to deliver some interesting photographs, such as the Vivid mode or the Classic Chrome mode that delivers a moody retro look. Besides all this, the Fujifilm X-T100 is capable of shooting excellent video with tons of detail and sharpness, so everything you could want from a mirrorless and more. At number 2, it's the Sony Alpha A6000. Next up, we have another mirrorless model, but this time around, it's from Sony's lineup, the Alpha A6000. This camera will bring more value than any other camera in the market, and on top of that, it'll make for a beautiful beginner-friendly camera with its wide range of features, such as its sensor, autofocus system, quick operation, compact dimensions, and lots more. You'll notice right from the first moment that the Sony Alpha A6000 is a pretty special camera, as it measures just 4.8 by 2.9 by 1.9 inches, and it weighs just 12.1 ounces, which is marvelous. However, this tiny body masks a beast, and its construction is not fragile at all, as it's constructed from the best materials. It also has a deep hand grip which makes it very easy to hold, and even in combination with large lenses it feels pretty balanced, which was quite surprising for its lightweight body. While being compact, this camera has a very detailed viewfinder on it, and a tilting 3-inch LCD screen that has a resolution of 921K dot. The controls are very intuitively placed and will deliver plenty of creative freedom on top of its user-friendliness. To deliver its amazing image quality, the Sony Alpha A6000 is packed with an advanced 24-megapixel APS-C CMOS sensor that's nearly full-frame, and on top of that, it's equipped with the Sony Bion's X processor, which is responsible for beautiful colours. There are tons of lenses available for this camera, and from the link below, you can get it with a nice bundle that'll deliver even more for its price. On top of all this, the Sony Alpha A6000 is pretty capable of shooting excellent video thanks to its amazing amount of controls you can choose from, and the hybrid AF system that supports great video. The hybrid AF is constructed of 179 phase detect points and 25 contrast detect points, which allow it to be extremely fast and accurate regardless of the lighting. The noise was handled properly as well in high ISO shots, and I have nothing to complain about with this camera. A supremely valuable camera from Sony. And at number 1, it's the Nikon D3500. Coming to the number 1 pick, we have the Nikon D3500, which has been one of the most popular beginner cameras in the market for a long time now, and for good reasons too. This camera is extremely versatile, has plenty of performance up its sleeve, delivers great value for its price, and it's the best in its range without a doubt. It's also extremely easy to use, has a touchscreen display, a great compact sizing and design, and many more features on top of its affordable price, so let's take a closer look. I'm going to dive straight in and talk about the performance of this beauty. The Nikon D3500 is packed with a nice 11-point multicam 100AF system that was also present in its predecessor, and it's one of the best ones for still and moving subjects. I found out that it focused super fast in good lighting conditions, and it wasn't far behind in dimly lit rooms, even with a kit lens, which was surprising. For delivering its perfect photographs, the Nikon D3500 is packed with a nice 24.2 megapixel APS-C CMOS sensor that was first used in this camera, and it delivered some great results combined with the X-Speed 4 image processor. The camera resolved a lot of resolution thanks to its lack of optical low-pass filter, and the ISO range was extremely wide considering that it's a pretty affordable camera. The Nikon D3500 is pretty fast as well for its price, as it can shoot 5 frames per second in burst shooting mode, and it has a marathon battery life of about 1,550 shots, so you can shoot plenty of photographs with it. The definite best beginner camera in the market.
Thanks for watching. I hope you liked the video. If you found it helpful, please remember to leave a like and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this in the future. If you have any questions related to these products, you can leave a comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.